Hello, Victor Tay from the church in Liverpool. I'm sure the two major parties want you to think that a vote for a party other than themselves is a wasted vote. Or you may have heard somebody say something like, you got to vote for major party A, otherwise you'll split the vote and help major party B get elected. But if you understand how votes are counted in Australian elections, you'll realise that this isn't true at all. Australia has a unique voting system in that we use a system called preferential voting, where you number the candidates in order of preference as opposed to only selecting the single candidate or party that you want to win. I won't go into the nuts and bolts of exactly how it all works, but I'll put a few links into the description below from the Australian Electoral Commission website for those of you who are interested, and you can learn more about it there. The articles are short, but the concepts may be a bit complex if mathematics is not your strong point. But here are three things I think are important to keep in mind when you go to the polling booths. Number one is preference your vote in the order you want the parties or candidates to win. Preferential voting means your vote can still contribute towards deciding the winner between the leading parties, even if your first preference wasn't one of them. Preferencing minor parties above major parties on your ballot is not a wasted vote. In fact, you are sending a strong message to the major parties that even though they were elected, they weren't your first preference. Minor parties generally have more specific policies because they are not attempting to appeal to the masses as the major parties do. And having them in the Senate to block bad legislation from the major party-dominated lower house is an important check and balance in our government. So I recommend putting your preferred minor parties before your preferred major parties when you vote. Number two is number as many boxes as you can. For the House of Representatives ballot, which is the small green one, you have to number every box in order for your vote to count. But for the Senate ballot, which is the big long white one, you have to number at least 1 to 6 above the line or 1 to 12 below the line for your vote to count. But you can number more than this in order to make sure that your vote doesn't exhaust. And that means your ballot runs out of preferences before being able to help a party obtain one of the available Senate seats. Even numbering parties you dislike in order of preference means you can specify how your vote is allocated to the lesser of many evils. Since the 2016 federal election, your vote can only be allocated according to the preferences that you have specified. Party preferences no longer determine where your vote goes, which is why we now have a minimum number of preferences we need to write in, as opposed to simply putting a 1 above the line for your favorite party. So I recommend you number all the boxes, obviously for the green one, but as many boxes as you can for the big long white one. And number three, make sure you vote and take your vote seriously. As Christians, I strongly believe it is our duty to be salt and light in the world and to influence our society where we are able to. So participating in our country's elections is just one practical way of doing that. I'd hate to think the low quality of government that we currently have in Australia is the result of well-meaning Christians who have decided not to participate in the voting process because of misguided principles. So I would encourage you to vote and take your vote seriously. Thanks for watching, and the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.